Good evening and welcome to the Merlin Show. My name is Siobhan Fitzgerald and today we have a guest, Margaret McCumber, and she is in great pain because she just lost her husband. Let's welcome Margaret McCumber.
Hello, darling.
You look great.
Is this yours?
Yes.
Oh, thank you. That's my question.
So, now, let me hear. How are you feeling today? Do you need tissue, honey? Are you okay?
It's okay. Oh, I keep thinking about the hunting accident where my husband died, and I just don't know how to deal with it.
Yeah, I understand. How long has it been since you lost your husband?
It's only a week ago.
A week ago? Oh, yes. Honey, I'm so sorry for your loss. Really. But let me hear. How did it happen?
McCumber and Wilson was out hunting buffaloes. And I had this terrible feeling because they were hunting them in their motor cars. And I kept saying that they shouldn't, and that they had to stay away, but they didn't listen. And then suddenly this buffalo was heading right towards McCumber, and I found a gun. And then I wanted to shoot the buffalo, but I hit McCumber right in the head instead. So I killed him.
Oh, honey. Someone has a tissue? Anyone? No? Oh, you can have some of my paper, please. Honey. Oh, I'm terribly sorry for your loss. I really am. Are you okay?
Yes.
So now let me hear. How did Wilson react to this accident?
Wilson was just talking all about this relationship I had to McCumber, and like he wanted to leave me anyway, so I could just have killed him earlier. But it was an accident, and we called the police and told them what happened, and so yeah, we just he was like he didn't care. Didn't matter to him because I actually think that he's in love with me, but
really?
Yes, I think so.
Oh
yeah. But and we're actually getting married.
So soon?
Yeah, no, but we'll just wait for a while so that it won't seem too busy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, we'll wait, yeah, in like half a year, I think.
Wow.
Yes. So
congratulations then.
Thank you.
So, you and McCumber had some problems in your marriage?
No, I don't think so, because, you know, I'm beautiful, and yes. McCumber, he was rich, and he had everything that a girl needed. So I felt like we were there for each other, and, you know, he would never get a wife as beautiful as me, and I would never get a husband as beautiful as him. No, not as beautiful, as rich as him.
Mm.
So, yeah, no, I think it was great, but I slept with Wilson when we were out on that hunting trip. Yes.
Wow. Did McCumber know?
Yeah, he got a bit mad, and he said that because I've done it before, actually. And then, but you know, it's so difficult for a woman like me to just stay with one guy. Yeah.
You're really gorgeous. Don't you all think that she's gorgeous? Yeah. Let's give her a hand. Oh, okay.
Thank you.
But let me hear then. Are you and Wilson then in love? Because it seems to me that you and McCumber's marriage were a bit superficial, perhaps, but you and Wilson are really in love, or is it just because you're in great
pain? You
know,
as a woman, I don't have anything to say. Don't you feel that way too? Like,
yeah.
You don't have anything to say.
Yeah.
I just feel like I have to do what I'm told to do, and yeah, I read he's handsome, he's a handsome man, and he has this interesting job where he shoots all these animals, and he you know, he's in danger all the time, but he loves it and he isn't afraid of dying.
He's like a real man or something like that.
He's a real man, yeah.
So Makamba wasn't like that.
No, but he became like that just right before I shot him. He was this amazing man who stood up for himself and shouted at me when I didn't do what he wanted me to do. And so, yeah, at last he was a real man. Oh, he was becoming a real man, but it was just a bit too late, I think.
But aren't you really sad about that then? Because he was a coward before, and now he grew to be this really, really brave man like that. Don't you miss him, and isn't that just so sad because he's gone now?
Of course it's sad because he man up, you know. I would have loved to make love to the new Makamba, and but now I have Wilson, and Wilson is like, he also looks like a real man. He's big and he's just gorgeous and
But he's working on safaris, right?
Yes.
Are you going to travel with him, or are you going to stay at home, maybe?
Sometimes I think I will come and visit him, because I know that he has a tendency to just sleep with all the other women who come there, so I have to stay there and, you know, be a bit in control.
But can you be in a relationship like that when you can't really trust him? You know that he's going to cheat on you if you're not there.
Oh, yes, but I think that he loves me more than he has ever loved any of the other women.
Aww.
So I hope that he'll just stay with me and not do, that he'll be faithful.
Okay. Oh, I'm so happy for you. I really am. But I'm truly, truly sorry that your husband died and that you had to shoot him. Not had to, but you shot him. But we all know that it wasn't on purpose, right? So
yes.
But let me hear. When is the funeral?
The funeral.
I can't remember. Yeah.
I really haven't thought about that.
Oh, you have so much on your mind. I totally understand. I think we all understand.
Yes.
Yeah. But
am I supposed to, like, arrange the funeral? Are you sure?
You didn't know that. You didn't know that it was your job.
I've never done anything by myself. I've always just lived this perfect life with Makamba, and he did all this stuff. I haven't ever done anything by myself.
But I'm sure that you can pay someone to do that job for you.
I hope so.
You've got all this money from Makamba now, so you can just pay someone. I can do it for you if you want to.
I think I have to leave. I'm sorry, I really have to leave. I can't.
Okay, but let us just all give Margaret a hand, please.
Yes,
thank you so much for coming. It was
thank
really
you.
Wonderful.
Thank you. Bye.
And goodbye. Bye. Okay, yeah. Okay. Yes, that was Margaret Makamba. Let's all give her a hand. And thank you very much, everybody. I gotta go now.
Ich bin jetzt los.